the hot spot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. So hot and
Miss Hat. You can catch me at the hot spot. It's the BRA 18. All right, y'all, Rick's About the Morning Show. Hey, the time right now is the bottom of the hour. Good morning, Brat.
Good morning, Ricky. Good morning, everybody. I'm your girl, Brat Tat Tat, and this is the hot spot where we bring you music, movies, and more. Oh, Lord, so let's get into it. Pastor Troy, he's a friend of the family, but he took a shot at Lil Nas X in the outfit he wore for the Grammys. He said, well, I guess I won't be winning a Grammy if this is what I gotta wear. They love to push this on our kids. He also recalled watching a gay couple kissing and laughing eating mozzarella sticks in an Applebee's commercial. He explained, first thing my 14-year-old son said was, man, F Applebee's, and it brought joy to my heart. He sees it. Their agenda is to take the masculinity from men, black men especially. Some may say he making money. RuPaul do it, but I ain't bumping his CD. Integrity is priceless. Y'all better open the third eye and let y'all sons know the real, or they ass gonna be headed down that old town road for real. The post was later deleted, and then Lil Nas X responded by saying, damn, I look good on that picture. And then Pastor Troy later addressed the comments in the video. He said it worked. It worked perfectly because now all these F's, derogatory what gay men do not appreciate being called, on my page want to fight me. See, that's that male aggression coming back in you. It's in you. You just got to let it hang out, and now you want to fight. That's what I'm talking about. Be a man. He ended with, there's a war going on, and y'all better be fighting. And he later deleted the post.
Oh, wow.
What?
That's crazy.
Yeah, that. Ugh.
I mean, you know, it's almost like you can't say anything. You say something, your damn career over, because I'm sure everybody have an opinion or
right.
whatever, you know. And then
everything is so touchy these days.
Yeah, I had somebody, you know, tell me that they don't like the way I talk heavy to my grandson and whatever, you know. And I'm like, you, ma'am, you don't get to tell me how to raise a man.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
And
what you want him to be one of them dudes out here that you don't want.
Right.
Okay. You know, or whatever. And if I raise him to be a man and to be masculine, then that don't mean that we anti-gay.
Right, right.
Well,
let's get on off of that. Moving on, y'all. Azriel Clary, that's one of the women that R. Kelly was a girlfriend with, a sister wife, or whatever you want to call it. she said that he has girlfriends in every city, flings in every city, three in each main city, so 50
what?
Times three. She said he makes everyone do degrading stuff, whether on film or writing it down, he makes them sign it. And I think a lot of women are ashamed or embarrassed to come out because of stuff like this, because it'll be incriminating them as well. He has letters of people saying that they've stole from him, that they've been molested or touched by their parents or brothers or a family member, even if it's not true. He even has people on film molesting their younger nieces or younger brothers. Thankfully, I've never been in that situation, but I've seen it done to other women. Yes, I have. That is very sad. Whew, Lord have mercy. Let me take a deep breath because these stories is deep today. And last but not least, our boy Offset, he was detained by cops yesterday in L.A. at a shopping center. The person had a gun, I guess. Whoever had a gun, somebody had a gun at the scene. Somebody called and said somebody had a gun. But the person whoever had the gun, they left the scene. And then Offset and his crew, of course, were detained. And TMZ posted footage of the rapper being detained, asking officers why he was being cuffed. And then they pushed him up against the wall. But anyway, they did recover two guns from Offset and three others from his crew, and they were taken to the police station for further questions. Whew, to get caught up on those stories and more, you can go to RickySmileyMorningShow.com. I'm your girl, Brat Tat Tat. Lord have mercy. We got to solicit the prayer warriors like Gary said, and that is the hot spot.
That is. I appreciate it, Brat. And I got your wake-up calls. What's the number, Brat?
It's 8669-RICKY. Once again, that's 1-866-9-RICKEY. Hit us up.